Hola, soy señora Nelson. Bienvenidos. Estamos aquí para que puedas master el idioma bellísimo que se llama el español. I'm here to help you truly, once and for all, accomplish your dream of mastering the Spanish language. So, like and subscribe. And today, let's get into it. I want to talk about the conditional tense, and I'm calling it the AP Cheater's Guide to the Conditional Tense because it comes with a story and it all has to do with AP Spanish class. Now, when I was in high school, I had Spanish 1, 2, 3, 4, and then AP Spanish. And in Spanish 4, that's where we learn the subjunctive tense, the conditional tense, and that is honestly where we just practiced speaking in Spanish. It was my favorite class because we got an A for talking, so I loved it. However, when I taught Spanish, our school had Spanish 1, 2, 3, and then we jumped into AP. And it was exponentially harder than when I was in high school and had to take AP Spanish. So I had a bunch of students who had never encountered the subjunctive tense, which makes everyone cry, much less the conditional tense, which also makes everyone cry. And on the AP test, there was a question they had to answer out loud in conversation in an authentic ebb and flow interview question type style. And 100% of the time, there was going to be at least one conditional tense. So today I'm teaching you what I taught my students, and it's the cheater's code, the way to stick it to the man, I suppose, the way to kind of cheat your way through the conditional tense if you've never learned it. Now, conditional tense, I teach about, you can learn it. Remember, if you go to elizabethteachesspanish.com, there I have different courses starting from scratch, nada, cero, and I'm slowly adding more and more courses for you to truly master and feel confident in the Spanish that you know. But if you don't have time for that, and/or if you've learned it in many moons ago, it's gone. Now, you can kind of learn how to maneuver your way and circumvent a crazy conjugation in order to still use the verb tense without actually using the verb tense. And it is the most beautiful verb called me gusta. Remember learning me gusta in like Spanish 1? Sí, claro, ¿verdad? Me gusta can also translate into me gustaría, which is the conditional tense. So my poor little students would get, si hoy fuera tu último día, ¿qué harías? Yo querría estar con mi familia. Yo haría un desayuno y, holy smokes, right? Whew, those poor little kiddos are thinking through, oh, it's an irregular conditional, so it would be me gustaría. Si hoy fuera tu último día, ¿qué harías? Bueno, me gustaría pasar tiempo con mi familia, me gustaría hacer un desayuno delicioso, me gustaría. Whew, because anytime you have a conjugated verb, the next verb is always, bueno, sí, always. It is always in the infinitive. If you throw in me gustaría, you can conquer with confidence any question they throw at you. So it didn't matter if my students had, si usted fuera el presidente, ¿cuáles leyes quería tener? Bueno, me gustaría tener una ley que dice, si tu persona favorita estuviera en tu casa, ¿qué harías con él? ¿Qué le dirías? Me gustaría jugar fútbol americano. Me gustaría decir, me gustaría cantar, me gustaría whatever. You have all the verbs, you just add in me gustaría. So you hear that crazy, I told my students, you hear that crazy verb tense and you're like, oh my goodness, what do I do? Me gustaría. Get the kind of gist, get the context of what they're talking about. Me gustaría. And you can talk about everything you want to. No me gustaría. Ah, sí me gustaría. Boom, short and sweet. If you want to practice and if you want to just get a feel for some of the types of questions my students would have encountered, and if you're in AP Spanish and you want just extra practice, whether actually answering the questions correctly or using the cheater's code Me Gustaría, I have a free download. Look in the description and you can go to ElizabethTeachesSpanish.com, throw in your email, and I'll shoot you a free PDF with the answers for the cheater's code Me Gustaría. Quite simple, but you can practice conditional tense or just a Me Gustaría tense. It's yours for free. So ElizabethTeachesSpanish.com, free worksheet for you right there. And like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week.